Is your photo library out of control? If it is, I'm going to explain how I organise my photos using Smart Collections and how my approach could save you a lot of time and frustration. Hello, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to Lenscraft. If there's something that most of us hate doing, it's organising our photo library. Now I must admit, I was once in this group and I let my library get years behind. As a photographer, my ideal is to be able to come back from a shoot and download the images from my camera. Then I can pick and process the best shots. But at some distant time in the future, I may want to somehow magically find a great shot of that frosty morning on Higator. Only problem is, I can't remember when I shot it. This is just what my current approach to organising photos can do. If you already have your own quick and easy approach, you probably don't need this. Last week I published a video explaining how you can use folders and collections to organise your photography. This week I'm going to build on that advice using Smart Collections. As before, I'm using Lightroom, but you can do the same thing in other software that supports Smart Collections, so things like Bridge, Exposure X5 or ACDC. I'll also include a link to my accompanying tutorial in the YouTube video information below. If you haven't used Smart Collections before, I think their power is going to surprise you. You can use them to build groups of photos automatically based on criteria you set. This means you don't need to spend time searching through lots of folders or images to pick the ones to add to the group. The best way to think of Smart Collections is being a filter that's applied to your entire Lightroom catalogue. To show you how this works, I've created a structure using collection sets. This is where I'll keep the Smart Collections that I create. If you don't know why I'm doing this, be sure to go back and watch last week's video using the link in the YouTube video description. The hierarchy I've created is one that makes sense to me as a landscape photographer, so you'll need to create something that makes sense for you. I've called my top collection set Finish Master Files. I'll be using this structure to hold all my finished images. As I explained in my previous video, every time I edit an image, I save the finished image as a Photoshop PSD file, and I call this my master file. I can then use this to create any other versions of my image, and I save everything in the same folder on my computer as the original raw file. I then use collections to gather all the finished master files into this hierarchy using Smart Collections to organise them. If you look under the finished master files, you'll see I've created three more collection sets. One to hold my abstract shots, one for my landscapes and another for my urban work. When I expand the landscape set, you can see three more sets which organise photos based on location. If I expand the UK landscape set, you can see it has two Smart Collections in there. There's a Smart Collection for the Lake District and another one for the Peak District. If I click one of these, you can see the images in them. Lightroom automatically selects these images based on the rules I've defined in the Smart Collection. If I right-click on one of these and pick the option to edit, you can see how I've set it up. At the top, there's a field to enter the name of the Smart Collection. Below this is a drop-down to set the rules to meet to include an image in the collection. Now currently I've got this set to all, meaning that an image needs to meet all three of these rules before it's included. The other options are any, which means the image only needs to meet any one of the rules, or we can set it to none, which would select all the images in Lightroom, but then exclude any image that meet the rules. A Smart Collection must have at least one rule defined, but you can add more rules using the plus icon. If you want to remove a rule, use the minus icon. Each rule has three parts to it. On the left is the thing that we want to check. Now there's a lot of these you can choose from, but I'm interested in checking the rating I've assigned to the image. In the middle column, I can set the logic for the rule. Because I only create master files for my best images, I only want those with two or more stars. Then, over on the right, I can set the level of the rating to use in the rule. If you look at my first rule, it's checking the star rating of my images and selecting any that have two or more stars. The next rule is checking the state or province of the image. This is one of the fields in the image metadata where you can add the location that you shot the image. The way I use this field is to add either the county or the area, like the Lake District or Peak District, when I import my images. In this rule, I'm checking to see if it's set to the Lake District. But there is a problem with this, as I've also got images from the Lake District region of Chile on my computer. I don't want those showing up in the Smart Collection as it's supposed to be UK landscapes. I can fix it by adding another rule to check the country location to see if it's the UK. The final rule is checking the file type. Ideally, I only want my finished master files in the Smart Collection. Because I always save these master files in the Photoshop PSD format, I can check for that. If you look at my collection panel, you can see that I've created a logical structure to organise my files, and I'm basing this on the photography I do and the location. I've then created individual collections to group together finished images based on this structure. The only thing I haven't explained is how the images have some of this information added to them, and that's all part of my workflow. When I come back from a shoot, I import my images to Lightroom. As part of the import process, I set Lightroom to automatically add the location information to every image. I also use the import process to create a new folder on my computer for each shoot. When I have the images in Lightroom, I look through them to apply a star rating, with the best images getting at least 2 stars. After that, I can process all the images with 2 or more stars. That's when I save the finished image as a Photoshop PSD master file. All the images relating to the shoot, including the master files, are in the same folder on my computer. But in Lightroom, I can go to the Collections panel to see my best work. When I click on a Smart Collection, I can see all the images in my Lightroom catalogue that are meeting the Smart Collection rules. Every time I process a new batch of images in this way, Lightroom just adds the best ones to the relevant Smart Collection. Lightroom's automating the organisation for me, and it's a huge time saving. As I mentioned earlier, there's a link to last week's video in the YouTube information. I've also included a link to my accompanying tutorial on my website. And if you want to learn even more about using the Lightroom Library module, check out my book. You'll also find the details on my website. I hope you found this video helpful. I'm Robin Worley. You've been watching LensCraft. I'll see you next week for another video. ¶¶